I got my leak detector here, so I'm just going to do a quick sweep of the coils. Maybe I'll adjust the sensitivity on this by pushing the sensitivity button here, right here, and that can adjust the sensitivity. I'll put it all the way up to the max sensitivity, and then just go ahead and sweep the probe around all the coils and just try to trace it back and see if I hear anything. Looks like it's reacting to if the probe touches the metal. So that's not really a leak, that's just the probe being set on its most sensitive. So I'm really not finding anything here. Looks like we got a few little bent fins up top here. No big deal, probably just when the unit was being cleaned. Okay, anyway, didn't find any leaks there. I'll have to check the back also. Okay, today I got a refrigerator that's low on Freon. I've got the unit unplugged right now. So in order to get this going, I'm gonna be taking off the back of the fridge here. And we wanna save this panel because this panel is actually engineered to help the system run properly. It lets a certain amount of air through at the back here, and it's good for the unit to have the cardboard there. So you don't want to just throw these cardboard pieces away. We actually need them or want them there. Okay. Final one there, and that'll give us access. We can look at our coils, and they look pretty clean, so, you know, first check on some small stuff. And then I'm also going to be looking for any leaks. And this does look kind of suspect right here. The brazed joint. I see some green deal here. So, let me grab a couple tools. Shed some light on the subject. Here's some light, so put some light there so you can see a little better. And just with the unit off, I've got my refrigerant sensor, leak sensor here. And again, adjust the sensitivity to be higher sensitivity. And using the probe, just go around this part right here. Yeah, I'm not hearing anything there. Anyway, now I'm going to plug the unit in. Again, being very careful not to touch anything. And there goes the compressor kick on. And it is reacting there, but I'm going to adjust the sensitivity to lower it down to the minimum. So you can see here it's at the minimum on the sensitivity. And then I'm just going to put a probe right here again. Definitely seems to be reacting with it right there. I think that's where our leak is. We see the green deal around it. So now just carefully what I'm going to do is use soap bubbles instead. And spray soap bubbles on it. You can be very careful. It's got voltage going there, so peek in here. Looks like right there. Very minor leak, look at that. Right there. There's our leak. It's very, very minor. And again, just seeing very minor bubbling right there. I think that's where our leak is, right here. Maybe just a bad solder job. And just for the heck of it, I'll check this side also on the high side. And the process stud. And everything seems okay there. Yeah, no bubbles there. Okay, on to the next mission.